Choreb Beruach,
Sword of the Spirit. Interpreted and narrated by Wendy. BeRashit, Genesis, Chapter 32.
And Joqub rose up. Then he set his sons and his wives upon camels, and he carried away all his livestock and all his goods, which he had gotten, the livestock he acquired, which he had gotten in Padan Aram, to go to Yitzhak his father, in the land of Canaan. Furthermore, Laban went to shear his sheep. Then Rachel stole the terebim, figures, that were her father's. However, Joqub stole the heart of Laban the Arami, upon no one telling him of his leaving. Thus he fled with all that he had. Then he rose up and passed over the river, and he set his face towards Mt Gileod. Then, on the third day, it was told to Laban that Joqub had fled. Therefore, he took his brethren with him and pursued after him 7 days' journey, and they overtook him in Mt Gileod. Moreover, Elohim came to Laban the Arami in a dream by night, and said to him, "Take heed that you do not speak to Joqub, either good or bad." Then Laban overtook Joqub. Now Joqub had pitched his tent in the mount, and Laban with his brethren pitched in the Mt Gileod. And Laban asked of Joqub, "Why have you done this? You stole my heart and carried away my daughters like captives with a sword. Why did you flee secretly and still, and did not tell me, that I might have sent you away with mirth and with songs, with tambourines and with harps? Yet you have not suffered me to kiss my sons and my daughters. Now, you were foolish in doing so. It is in the power of my hand to do you harm. But the Elohim of your father spoke to me last night, saying, 'Take heed that you do not speak either good or bad to Joqub. Now surely you should go, because truly you long after your father's house. But why have you stolen my deities?' Then Joqub answered and said to Laban, 'Because I was afraid, for I said, perhaps you might snatch your daughters from me. With whomever you find your deities, let him not live. Before our brethren, discern what is yours amongst me, and take it unto yourself.' For Joqub did not know that Rachel had stolen them. Therefore Laban went into Jakub's tent, and into Leah's tent, and into the two maidservants' tents, but did not find. Then he went out of Leah's tent, and entered into Rachel's tent. Now Rachel had taken the terebim, and put them in the camel's furniture, and sat upon them. Thus Laban searched all the tents, but found nothing. And she said to her father, "Let it not displease my lord that I cannot rise up before you, for the custom of women is upon me." Thus he searched, but did not find the terebim. Therefore Joqub was wroth and rebuked Laban. Then Joqub responded and asked Laban, "What is my trespass? What is my sin that you have so hotly pursued after me? Since you have searched all my belongings, what have you found of all your household things? Set it here before my brethren and your brethren, that they may judge between us. These 20 years I have been with you. Your ewes and your she-goats have not lost their young, and the rams of your flock I have not eaten. That which was torn of beasts I did not bring to you. I carried the loss of it. From my own hand you required it, stolen by day or stolen by night. There I was, During the day, the drought consumed me, and the frost by night, and my sleep departed from my eyes. Thus I have been 20 years in your house. I served you 14 years for your 2 daughters, and 6 years for your flock, and you have changed my wages 10 times. If not for the Elohim of my father, the Elohim of Abraham, and the dread of Yitzhak had been with me, surely you would have sent me away empty by now. Elohim has seen my affliction and the labor of my hands. Therefore, he rebuked you last night. Then Laban replied and said to Joqub, "These daughters are my daughters, and these children are my children, and this flock is my flock, and all that you see is mine. But what can I do this day to these my daughters, or to their children who they have birthed? Now therefore, come, let us make a covenant, you and I, and let it be for a witness between you and I." Then Joqub took a stone and set it up for a monument. Moreover, Joqub said to his brethren, "Gather stones." Thus they took stones and made a heap. Then they ate there, upon the heap. And Laban called it Yagar Shadahuta, but Joqub called it Galad, witness heap. Therefore Laban said, "This heap is a witness between you and I this day." Thus the name of it is called Galad, and Mitzpah, watchtower. For he said, "He who exists watches between you and I, when we are absent one from another. If you afflict my daughters, or if you take other wives beside my daughters, no man with us will see. Elohim is the witness between you and I." Then Laban said to Joqub, "Behold this heap, and behold this monument, which I have cast between you and I. This heap is a witness, and this monument is a witness, that I will not pass over this heap unto you, and that you will not pass over this heap and this monument unto me for harm. The Elohim of Abraham, and the Elohim of Nahor, the Elohim of their father, judge between us." And Joqub swore by the dread of his father, Yitzhak. Then Joqub offered a sacrifice upon the mount, and called his brethren to eat bread. Therefore they ate bread and tarried all night in the mount. Then, early in the morning, Laban arose and kissed his sons and his daughters, and he blessed them. Then Laban departed and returned to his place.